Today I had a mind to tell you about what's happening in the other lokas which we don't see, of which we are not aware. It may frighten you a little bit, but the time has come for us to know how are we placed in relation to the whole. What are the plans of the Divine and how are we going to fulfill them? Now, most of you are here realized souls. Some of you have come first time, you will also get your realization. But the common point is that you are all seekers, seekers of God, seekers of peace, seekers of love. That's a common. But this seeking has come to you not for your own sake, for an individual ascent, or for some achievements of a place from where there is no return. But this is the last judgment that all the human beings have to face. They have to go through it and to achieve their place in the kingdom of God. Today you are sitting before me, you have been with me before and much before. But today especially, when you are with me, you have come here to face up to it and to see for yourself that you are able to bear the truth, the love, the blessings of God, that you can enter into the kingdom of God and abide there in His reign with all His powers flowing through you. It has been promised before, all promises are to be fulfilled. All scriptures are to be supported and are to be proved. But we must know that there is a great war going on between satanic forces and divine forces. And all the satanic forces, who symbolized as devils, in Sanskrit language they are called as Rakshasas, Asuras and all that, have taken their birth on this earth to demolish the kingdom of God. Imagine, what ambitions. But they want to demolish this kingdom of God in your hearts. The kingdom of God exists, will exist, it's eternal. It has created universes after universes. It has created human beings from amoeba to this stage. It has brought you to this position that today you are here to receive your ultimate goal. It all has happened now. At this critical moment, at this precious moment, when you are about to enter into the kingdom of God, all these forces are built up to pull you down. It lies in your wisdom to understand that the forces are very subtle, extremely cunning, beyond your comprehension. Even after entering into self-realized state, you have noticed how they act on you. Try to drag you down, pull you down. This war is played not on the conscious plane as it was played before. Say one Rakshasa coming in, it was all right to kill him. He came as a Rakshasa, he came as a devil, he was killed, finished. But today they have come as godly men, as God men as they call them, as God women. They call themselves as God, gurus. They have come in the garb of religion. these ancient Rakshasas have taken their birth. And they have gone into the minds of the seekers. Thousands and thousands of seekers they have captured. Imagine the situation is so precarious and so dangerous. They have entered into the minds of the people who are the seekers, who are the ones who are to be bestowed with this kingdom, who are to be enthroned, who are to be crowned, have been destroyed, tortured by these horrible forces. And because it is not in your conscious plane, you cannot see them, you cannot feel them, you cannot understand them, how dangerous they are. While they have learnt all the methods of coming into your ego or into your superego to influence you, that war we all have to fight. If we have to establish ourselves fully in the kingdom of God, we must know that we have to fight all those pulling forces. Sahaja Yoga is not meant for useless people. It's not meant for people who have no courage. It's not meant for cowards. It's not meant for people who run after money and who run after all these material things, especially the first people who are the foundation of Sahaja Yoga. They have to be people of great caliber and of great desire to achieve their state of emancipation. Because they are the people who are going to save the whole humanity. They are the redeemers. They are the ones who are going to manifest the salvation of this doomed humanity. Those who are weak can be strengthened because the energy lies within them. Those who are unhealthy can be cured. Those who are mentally disturbed can be brought round. But there is no place for cowards in this. You have to be courageous and cheerful people. For one thing, because you represent that force which is fighting for the Divine, for God Almighty. You are His hands. And you have to be wise also. Stupid people are no good. Stupidity can never help you to rise. You have to be wise people. Useless people, those who run after nonsensical things, let them go wherever they like. They'll come back when their time and turn will come. We need not be many people for this. Very few can save the world, but they have to be strong and absolutely established in their understanding of the powers of their spirit, powers of their Father who is Almighty. Don't worry what happened to you before getting your realization. Those who ponder over these things will not achieve much. Past is finished now. Today you are facing me and I am facing you. This is the present. It is not possible for me to give you the complete vision of the great war that is on and how you are to be saved. The tempest, I feel, in a boat, I'm putting my children in, try to keep in the center to keep the gravity all right. And when you'll get strong enough, you will row the boat with me Do not hate yourself. Do not torture yourself and don't feel guilty, by which you become very, very weak. What is there to feel guilty? I don't understand. Imagine a warrior and a soldier feeling guilty at the time when the war is on. You have to be full of enthusiasm and full of valor. All these small petty things which destroy your spirit, throw them away. No place for all these fashionable things of feeling guilty. This is the weakness of the West. If you have to progress fast, and if you want all this to be achieved, time is very short. You have to realize that. There is no time for hanky-pankies, as you call it, but there is no time also for going round the places. You have to settle down now. You have to get to it. So many realized souls are born today as children in all the communities, even in Russia. Can you imagine? Russians are going to come to Sahaja Yoga. I've been there. They may be the first, because they have reasoned out all the nonsense of the so-called religious and the religiosities and all the nonsense of the false people who preach religion. There is no place for false gurus in Russia. No place. Also for real gurus, there is no place. So you have to enter there through their children. And children will recognize Sahaja Yoga. Within 10 years' time, everything has to spark. It does not matter how you do it, but you have to do it. For me and for the Divine, you are the most important things. Doesn't matter if there is an earthquake and few horrible buildings fall down. It makes no difference to the Divine. What is important is how many are aware, how many are progressing, how many are settling down. Those who are very frightened type have no place in Sahaja Yoga. That means you are still playing into the hands of these negative forces. Imagine frightened people coming as soldiers for Sahaja Yoga. All the powers that are within you will start manifesting when you show your valor. When you are not even willing to raise your hand, how your sword is going to work? In India, now there are thousands and thousands of Sahaja Yogis, and they are progressing fast. We have to see now in the West, how are we going to progress and how are we going to settle down. It takes time in the West, no doubt, to settle down. Though realization is much quicker. Indians get, as I always say, that they are difficult nuts to be cracked. Even British are like that, compared to other Europeans. But those who get realization also go down very fast sometimes. But British ones, they get it all right in their nuts. They're good. There's something about the tradition, maybe. But still, don't take too much time to get your realization. Why should you get too much time to get your realization? You just desire it, and it will work. It's only your desire that is going to awaken it. Desire it from your heart. Now to outwardly. It's a fashion nowadays to be a seeker. No, it is an urge. You cannot live without it. You have to find it out. You try anything else. People are committing suicide because they have not been able to find out their own meaning. And that's why it is very important that you must take Sahaja Yoga, not just like a shopping center, as like guru shopping, but very seriously. Because your meaning is there to be found out. but your purpose, and then the manifestation of your purpose, that has to happen. Sahaja Yoga started working in three phases. In the West, I think, first, that people got their realization to see that there's wrong with them, where they have got something wrong. The attention was taken inside by which they could see that they have problems. If you do not see your problems and somebody says that you have problems, you will hit that person very badly. It's better that you see for yourself that there is a problem. Once you see that problem within yourself, you will be anxious to see that you get rid of it. But if you do not see a problem, you think that you are doing very great jobs and you are very great and you are perfectly all right. Or else if you see also some of the defects, because some people write that this is wrong, that is wrong, then you become guilty. Both ways is wrong, because one way you go towards ego, the other way you go towards superego. So through awakening, you start seeing yourself, which side you lie, what's the problem. You start judging yourself. The first judgment starts by yourself. Mr. So-and-so, judge yourself. Here you are, the mirror, now see. This is what it is. So you judge yourself, and you want to get rid of it. You don't want it anymore within you. Then the second trouble starts, when you start judging others. First you judge others, you get frightened. Oh God, horrible vibrations, run away. We'll get caught up. Gradually you get immune. Ah, we've known this type, we've known that type, we've known that type, we've known that. All these types we know. Then you do not condemn anyone, but you love, and in that love, you judge. Because you want others to get rid of their problems, you help, you share their problems to begin with. And the joy of giving realization starts working in you, to others. Now the problems start when you look around, Western society I'm talking about, you find your society is in doldrum. What's the problem? Why the society is in the doldrum? What has happened? What basics have we lost? What part of the sustenance of human being is lost? Why? So you find about your marriage institutions, about your relationship with each other. That has to be settled. That has to give you joy, real joy of companionship and love. And in the third phase, the great who are trying to be born on this earth, so many of them, they're around here, just here, watching. They have to be born. You have to be parents of those children. They are going to blast all these satanic forces, because they know what these satans are like and how they are to be blasted. They are experts. I've seen so many of them, and you have seen also. They know what is Kundalini, they know how to raise it, and they know how to blast all these people. And then the whole society of realized souls is going to pull out this humanity. Everyone need not be brought to Sahaja Yoga. They'll be all pulled out. We must have sufficient pulling force within us. So those who come to me earlier have a greater responsibility than those who will be coming much later, say after 10 years. They'll be just jumping into it. You are the ones who are going to do that. So, judge your self-esteem and do not try to condemn yourself for anything. That's forbidden in Sahaja Yoga, you know that. You are all saints. So many saints sitting here, imagine. The gods are singing. The angels are showering all their joy upon you. What a meeting it is! What a force it is! The auspiciousness of this meeting acts not only in England, not only in Europe, but in the whole universe. But the channels have to be strong enough to manifest. That's why today I said, I have to say something really serious. On the 27th, we are going to have a big puja, you know that. And I would like you to think about what I've said today. And I would like you also to proclaim within yourself that you will establish this Mahayoga on this earth, that you will bring the blessings of this golden age on this earth, which was created for this. The whole creation will find its own meaning. May God bless you.